I don't know if you can see that very much, but I just brought that in just a little bit and just came down and smoothed it off just a little bit and got right in the center. Now my drill bit's going to go right in that part right there. I'm going to flip it over and do the other side. Got the lines, and there's the ports that go down, and I'll be drilling a hole in this angle right here, and it'll come out about a 1/16 of an inch above the bottom of that. And the way I'm going to do that is I'm going to go ahead and put that in, and then I will tilt the angle to move this up or down, and I'll line this up with the drill press. Now you won't be able to see it because I can't get my camera angle, but the way it'll be, the drill press will be going down an angle just like this, and I'm going to move this. I'll just show you. That'll be, and I'll move this up in this angle right here till I get it at the same angle that I want. Then tighten it up, and it'll be there, and it should go in just fine. I won't be able to film this because my camera angle is not right. My shop is just too close together to do that right now. But we'll see how it goes, and you'll see the result of it. But I've got everything at an angle. I've got it tightened down. It's in the vise. And what I've done is I've just lined up that drill bit right there with the line that I put on. And then I come around the front part of it right here and take a look at it. And then I can make sure that I'm not drilling into this port right here. I just want to come right in from this hole right here, straight through to that port right there. And also, when you do this, make sure that you lock your quill because you won't be able to see the tip. So you lock your quill by looking at here. I can see exactly the direction or the path that that drill bit's going to take. And I should break through right above the wall of that right there. And you don't want to go into that center one. So all I need to do now is make sure I've got everything locked. And it is. The quill is locked. My vise is tight, so now I just bring this back up, come on over in the middle, and I've already lined that up. That's all lined up straight. That's straight. So now I just need to get this over my center mark and start the drilling. That's a number 33 drill bit, in case somebody's wondering. That's a number 33. All right, well, let's see how we're going to come out on this thing. All right, if I did that right, and it looks like I see filings coming out of the bottom of that thing. Let's see if I've got a little piece of music wire. All right, when you're hunting a piece of wire, you think I'd find it. I found an old piece of an antenna. I don't want to cut it off, but there it is. Came through, didn't go any farther than what it's supposed to. So, job is half done. Now I'm going to turn it over, do exactly the same thing from the other angle. Okay, there's one more operation to the cylinder, and it's just straightforward. And that is, I've got to have an inlet and an exhaust. And that's what this center port here is. So on this one, I just need to come in and drill straight down to get to that port. That's just going to be just a straight up milling operation. I'm going to use the same 33 bit and just drill down on each side. Now you may be asking, how come I didn't go ahead and see what center depth? Not overly concerned about the center depth. All I need to do is break through because I'm going to go exactly on the other side and do the same thing. really, I could just drill straight through if I wanted to. So if I break through, that's all I'm worried about. If I go a little bit deeper, it's not nearly as critical this one as it was the other one. Again, just gonna go through with the number 33 drill bit. Now when I put my exhaust on here and my intake, at that time, I can either, because I've got a good almost 3/8, perhaps 7/16 of an inch down to that port. If I need to, or I will, not if I need to, but what I will do is I'll go ahead and I'll drill out about 1/4 inch or so and use a bottoming tap, and I'll either tap or JB weld or Loctite the exhaust and the input in piping into the steam engine when I go. Let me just go put that down through there and I should be able to get started. Okay, and that was broken through. I'm just going to do exactly the same thing on the other side. Just going to go ahead and center it, edge find it, and drill. I'll go ahead and double check and make sure that it did go all the way through. And you can't see it, but there's the wire. See if I can put just a little bit of bend in it. Well, it's not coming out, but anyway, it did go all the way through. So I'm just going to do exactly the other side and do the same thing. Well, for me, the hardest part of the engine has been completed. And I know different people have different trepidations, I suppose, about the different parts of the engine to build. But to me, drilling the cylinder passages are the most difficult. And one reason is I just don't have a whole lot of equipment to do that precision type stuff as it goes. And this one here, of course, goes all the way across with nothing in the middle. So that one goes across. This one right here came up through that end just fine. Did not go into the other wall. This one, of course, goes in this way. The walls here are intact and it did not come out anywhere below that. And so now I've got a really nice cylinder and that turned out very nice. So that'll go up here on top of the engine. Actually, it'll be like that. It's about time for me to start bolting some of this stuff together. By the way, there was a comment about I did not show the drilling of these holes here. And I think in retrospect, perhaps I did not do that. But all I did was just drill the holes here for the size of the tap, then did a transfer punch to the bottom of those, and then I enlarged the brass bushing for the set screws. Again, the socket head set screws are only for assembly. When I get through with it, I'll actually be using machine bolts. In fact, I may end up having to make machine bolts. These are British threads, and I don't have any British thread taps. I just use American taps all the way through. So, very pleased. Now on to the cylinder cap up here. And the reason there's no holes drilled in this part right here, I'll use the cylinder cap or the cylinder head to transfer the holes from it over to the cylinder itself. That wraps it up for this one. Thanks for watching. See you on the next section.